Sailing just concluded at the Tokyo Olympic Games, and I'm sure a lot of you guys are wondering, how do I qualify for the Games? Well, the process is a little bit convoluted, and it took me a while to find this information, but today, I'm going to shed some light on the process to become an Olympic sailor. Before we get started, my name is Mickey. I'm an aspiring Olympian myself in the new Mixed 470 class, and my channel is all about bringing the tips and tricks that the very top sailors use and giving them to everybody so that everybody can join in the pursuit of becoming an awesome sailor, just like I'm trying to do right now. And even if you're not into that, subscribe just to follow my journey and have a lot of fun along the way. If you enjoy the video, don't forget to press the thumbs up. It helps a lot. And if we can get to 20 thumbs ups, then I will do a Q&A where I answer all of your burning sailing questions. All that out of the way, let's get into the video. So the first thing you need to know is there is a cap or quota on how many sailors can go to the games, and it is 350 athletes. In terms of the class breakdown, the RSX Windsurfer can send 25 boats for the men and 27 boats for the women. The laser can send 35 boats for the men and 44 boats for the women. The fin class can send 19 men because it's a men's only class. And the 470 and the 49er can send 19 men and 21 women. And the mixed knacker 17 can send 20 boats. So that would be 40 sailors. So not a ton of spots, and each country can only send one team per boat. Number two thing you need to know, you can qualify your country for the games, but not actually qualify yourself. So here's how the qualification process works, and this is for World Sailing, which is our international governing body. So just like we have US Sailing to manage sailing in America, World Sailing sets the standards for sailing around the world. So for Tokyo, that was the 2018 World Sailing Championship in Aarhus, Denmark. That determined about 40% of the qualifying spots. From there, World Sailing used the individual world championships, so say a 470 world championship, a laser world championship, to determine somewhere between 4 and 10 additional spots for each class. And from there, it was kind of down to Pan Am Games, African Games, Oceanian Games, more regional games to determine what countries qualified. And those events, basically the top one or two boats would qualify for a spot at the games. Number three thing you need to know, the US has a multi-step process for selecting what athletes they send to the games. So now that you've qualified your country for the Olympic Games, you need to focus on qualifying yourself for the Olympic Games. According to the US Sailing website, which this took me a bunch of digging to find, but to qualify for the Tokyo Games, there are basically three stages. There's early selection, mid selection, and late selection. In order to achieve early selection, a boat must finish in the top three in at least one of the regattas listed in the first set of regattas, cumulative series score of 7 points or less in the same boat class from one event in set number one, plus the event in set number two, which was the 2019 World Championship, and be the only US boat to achieve these events. So basically, the example from US Sailing was if a boat wins the 2019 Olympic test event and they get 6 in the World Championship, then they have a cumulative score of 7 points or less, so your points equals your finish, and they qualify for the Olympic Games. Pretty simple, right? Well, that's a hard score to achieve. But if another US boat also was kind of in this range, then you'd have to move on to mid-selection. So fourth thing you need to know is that there's three tiers to US Sailing selection. Let's go through mid-selection. The events outlined for mid-selection are the 470 World Championship in 2019, so one of the early selection events. And then the second event is the 2020 World Cup in Miami. So let's read through what US Sailing has to say. In order to achieve mid-selection, a boat in the five classes listed above must finish in the top 8 in the 2019 World Championship and have a cumulative score of 13 points or less from the two events listed and be the only US boat to achieve this result. If no boat has achieved the mid-selection process, they'll move on to late selection. So basically, if you're top 8 at the World Championship, so say 8th place, then you can do anywhere from 1st to 5th at the World Cup Miami, and that will qualify you to be on the US team for the Olympic Games. However, if you can't do that, then we're gonna move on to the final stage of selection. Last thing you guys need to know, number five, is that late selection happens really close to the Olympic Games. I mean, 2019 is only a year and a half away from the 2020 Games. Although it ended up being a lot later, even the early selection is really late. So even if somebody else qualifies your country for the Olympic Games, you still have some time to actually take that spot from them. So for the late selection, there were three events laid out. Number one was the 2019 World Championship in Enoshima. The second one was the 2020 World Sailing Cup Miami. And the last regatta was supposed to be the Princess Sofia regatta in Palma de Mallorca, Spain. So basically, no longer is there this cutoff for to qualify. It's basically who has the best score across this regatta series of three events. So even if you're third to last and there's two U.S. boats finishing under you, if you've already qualified for the games, the U.S. is going to have to send you. Late selection, especially if your country is not doing as well in one of the classes, for example, the 470 women went down to the wire, down to the very last event, which is something I'd love to talk to later if you guys want to. So comment below if you want me to talk about the 470 women's battle to go to Tokyo, because it's fascinating. But basically, that is the process for qualifying your country for the games and qualifying yourself for the games. So hopefully that wasn't too long, and hopefully you guys really enjoyed the video. Let's get this up to 20 likes, and I'll do a cool Q&A. And yeah, talk to you guys soon. Peace.